Oh, it's so nice to be with you. I love all the things you say and do. And it's so nice to hear you say you're gonna please me in every way. Honey, I got the notion you're causing commotion in my soul. Baby, you and me have got something that's real. I know it's gonna last a lifetime.
Welcome, everybody, to the 50-year reunion of Conneaut High School Class of 1973. It's really great to see how people have come a long way or a short way or any way to come here and recognize the importance of this eventful occasion. It's really great to see all the familiar faces and names on the name tags that are attached to rather unfamiliar faces. It doesn't take long, though, to recognize the classmate behind the name once you know the name. Tonight's turnout is just absolutely magnificent, better than any of us could have expected. We have, I believe, about 65 classmates here. I think there's a few people's names still in the basket there. If you haven't got a name tag yet, if somebody hasn't found you, or if you haven't found the person whose name tag you have, after I'm finished speaking, if you wouldn't just go up to the basket there and get the correct names and fix that up, okay? Because some of the people haven't arrived yet, so some people here haven't got their names. So 65 people here in attendance, and a lot of other people who couldn't be here tonight have sent messages expressing their regret and wishing us that we have a great reunion, and I'm sure that many of them are thinking about us right now. And we, of course, especially remember those classmates who left us far too soon. And Pam's memoriam table there is a beautiful and fitting tribute to our lost classmates. So it's my privilege to be a part of a fantastic committee that's been working really hard for the past year to organize the events of last night and tonight. And we have several special things planned for us all to enjoy. So I would like to extend a special thank you to Bill Lundgren, Beth Webb Pyle, Pam Casey Pinney, and Linda Latva. And again, thank you to Patty Anderson and Marcia Rains Richards for their contribution, and especially for organizing last night as well. Now, I mean, who could believe how quickly 50 years could go by? I heard that so many times last night as well, and that's the first thing I thought, you know, what happened? We're just going about our day-to-day activities. We go to college, we go to work, we got married, we raised some kids, we watched them grow, they have children of their own, and here we are half a century later, and time just keeps on moving forward. It'd be nice if we had a time machine to go back. How great would that be, you know? But I suppose tonight and this weekend were really the next best thing. It's like we have gone back in time, so let's all go back to 1973. Let's hear the music that we listened to in high school. Let's talk to our friends. Let's relive the memories. In the next several hours, we can be like Marty McFly. Go back to our school days. Let's make the most of it. Let's raise our glasses to the class of 1973.
Yeah.
Cheers. Thank you.
Thank you.
And the sign said, long-haired freaky people need not apply. So I tucked my hair up under my hat, and I went in to ask him why. He said, you look like a fine, upstanding young man. I think you do. So I took off my hat.
I went to a garden party to reminisce with my old friends. Chance to share old memories and play our songs again. When I got to the garden party, they all knew my name. No one recognized me, I didn't look the same. But it's alright now, I learned my lesson well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself. People came from miles around, everyone was there. Yoko brought a walrus, there was magic in the air. And over in the corner, much to my surprise, Mr. Hughes hidden Dylan's shoes, wearing his disguise. But it's alright now, I learned my lesson well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself.
The stars.